But yeah, and then there was the thingy with the thingy. You know how making content is difficult? And like whenever you want to find something, you know, people can't see shrugs on audio podcasts.
Hashtag shrugged.
Darkrai shrugged.
Darkrai sad.
Wanna be the very best, like no one ever was. Catch them, my request to train them is my cause. I would travel across the land, searching far and wide. Each Pokemon to understand the power that's inside. Pokemon, gotta catch them, it's you and me. Though it's my destiny, oh, and my best friend in a world we must defend. That's so true.
What happened to Lauren?
And I'll teach you, Pokemon. Gotta catch him.
Where's Lauren?
Oh, she's in our hearts is where she is. Speaking of Lauren, I watched the Red Hand of Denial live stream on Instagram today, and it was Lauren in the booth recording new vocals for their new album, and it was really fascinating and entertaining to watch.
I saw that, but I was watching The Bad Batch,
You
so
messed up. You messed up. Oh, you're talking about the Disney announcing all their stuff to their investors and or whatever.
no, The Bad Batch, like the new Star Wars animated show
Right, I thought they
on
announced a
Disney
bunch
Plus.
of new Star Wars stuff though.
Yeah, but I watched The Bad Batch came out today. An
Oh,
episode came out today.
a episode of it actually came out
Yes.
today. Oh, I thought it was just announcements. Oh, does it not, when you see it, does it not look like bad bitch? Just a bad bitch.
Are you dyslexic?
Look at the logo and at a glance, tell me if it says bad bitch. Hey everybody, welcome to Pokemon After Darkrai. My name's Brett.
I'm Hannah.
And it was me and fuck, who was it, Hannah? You tell me.
Ducklet.
Ducklet, the Lord Cannibal friend Ducklet. It was also Malamar, our master of disguise of this journey that we're going on together, you and I. You and me and we. And also Christ in a bucket. It's been a long time. So like say for instance, if someone was planning a massive heist and took notes on it and then they had to put it aside because someone was gone for a long time, and there they are, February 16th, 2021. Then we also had Tyrantrum, who is our getaway driver. And finally, Berserker, which is the old veteran wild card of the group. And we were planning the heist of whatever it was I said we were planning a heist for several months ago. Hannah, do you remember what I was planning a heist for?
No.
Pretty sure it was probably the Poke Bank where they keep all the Poke coins and Poke monies. And also
The Doge coins, where they keep all the Doge coins.
where they keep all the crypto mons, all the Porygon Zs doing
Yeah,
all
there
the
you go.
mining.
The crypto mons.
Yeah, there's got to be a Pokemon that starts with crypt, right? That I'm just not thinking of. That'd have been
But
perfect
that's a
there.
coin.
Cryptogonals are in there. Get it? Ha. And so we're gonna plan to break in there. They also have like the trophy for Pokemon League champion, and I don't want them to have that. And meanwhile, I'm also going to upload a virus that will somehow sneak into a Pokemart. Actually, you know what? Never mind. I'll save that for later. Don't worry about what I just said there.
What is happening right now?
So anyway, I had my crack team, and we pull up to the place, and it's at night. We helicopter in. We pull up in our helicopter, I mean. and we climb out. It has wheels. Don't worry about it. We climb up a nearby gutter. Tyrantrum's not with us at this point. He's like nearby, like a couple blocks away, probably eating pizza or something, like a cool radical dude.
Had pizza for lunch today.
Tyrantrum looks like a Ninja Turtles bad guy, but that's beside neither here nor there. Congratulations on your pizza. I hope it had pineapple. So we're on
it
the roof.
Did.
So we're on the roof and we're looking for a means of ingress. And we come across a vent. This vent is practically ducklet shaped. So ducklet sneaks through and we hear a clang clang slash slash. And then the door to the roof access opens. We climb down the ladder and only to find that ducklet had encountered a security guard whom he promptly did what, Hannah?
He killed him and ate him.
Wow, you're a disturbing individual. I was just going to say yes to whatever you said, but I guess he killed him and he ate him. Very quickly, finger looking good and all. So we made our way past that. We eventually found our way to the security guard checkpoint. And we began searching around for the keys. And Hannah, please remember that when we come back next time so that I can continue the story of the heist. Bum, ba, dum, ba, dum, bum. Heist. Bum, ba, dum, ba, dum, bum. Heist. 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 Heist.
You want me to remember that?
Yeah, that's right. And this is that show that I said it was. And oh boy, Hannah.
Oh boy, Brett.
Don't yell at me. So real quick, a bit of news before we get going. We're gonna move back Darkrai, this show, to a bi-weekly schedule. It'll just make life a little bit easier on me. My work is kind of nuts, so I don't have quite as much. I get time off, but I don't get like evenings off necessarily where it's convenient for Hannah to get on a call with me for an hour, if that makes any sense. It's been difficult. And like, for instance, I'm off this weekend, but next two weekends I work and they're 12-hour shifts and I'm not always capable of performing after a 12-hour shift.
I don't blame you, dude. Well, plus so, it's summertime. Okay, continue. I'm sorry.
You're fine. That's my job. How dare you steal it?
Sorry.
But also, I just want to say, like, Hannah gets tired of me saying, you want to record a show? You want to record a show? You want to record a show? And, like, grabbing onto her ankle saying, you can't leave me! Furthering the codependence of my happiness on her and my need for her to be on this show. So it'll just make it easier for me to make the show on one hand and two, to keep Hannah around longer. I'm just kidding. You weren't going anywhere.
I know. I'm here.
But it'll just make...
I'm here like glue. I'm sticky. Wait.
Hannah, is that the title of this episode? Hannah Sticky?
Ew, please don't.
Wait, let me get my pen.
No, put it down.
No, it's happening.
Down the pen. No, it's
happening. I gotta write it. Beware Hannah Sticky.
Hi, Mom. I don't know why that made me. I was just thinking, I'm like, man, your mom is gonna like look at that title and be like,
did you catch anything? This is a Pokemon show. So anyway, hang on. We'll go back to every other week, which is what we used to do in the first place, but just being every other week. We wanted to do every week. We wanted to see if we could do it. I think we succeeded and we could do it. It's a lot of work, but also, I mean, what happened because of it? I got more tired.
Yeah.
I mean, not a lot. Why are you sorry for it? Like not a lot has changed. Nothing's changed for us really since we did them weekly. So we're going to go to bi-weekly. We'll still be around. Hannah promises to be more active in the Discord. When people say nice things about her, she'll respond and say thank you, right, Hannah?
Oh, I suck at Discord. I apologize. I super suck at Discord.
All of my co-hosts are terrible at Discord.
I swear to God, like, I even used to do IT for like 7 years. Mm-hmm. And even my husband's like, what happened to you? You used to know all this stuff. I guess just where I don't want to sound like that old person. Like, I don't know what a hashtag is, but like,
hashtag, I don't, what's a hashtag?
Yeah, I like suck at Discord and I'm so sorry. I know Rahaze has like, oh my God, he's messaged me a couple times, like, or like tagged me and stuff, and I keep forgetting to respond. So I'm sorry.
Terrible.
I suck. I know.
Love you, Rahaze.
Yes.
Speaking of Rahaze, he totally carried me in a Xerneas raid. Was it today? It was either today or yesterday. But I guess everyone was busy and I was off work. And I,
oh yeah, you,
one of my people didn't show up.
Was that at like 10:30 this morning?
Was that when it was? Time is an illusion as far as I can tell.
I was busy checking lead in the hospital. So,
well, one of our people didn't show up, and I didn't see that he was online. I just said, well, I'm gonna send this invite to him just in case. I know he loves to raid, and sure enough, he showed up and carried everybody.
Yeah, because he's what, almost level 50.
Almost if level not 50.
If not level 50.
He's our beastliest friend. Moving on. We got to move on. We have to do it.
Okay.
You know,
okay.
We have to. Pokemon Go news. Are you ready?
Can we start with the most exciting thing?
Sure. Hannah is sticky.
Course, it's the only piece of news that I know because I haven't really looked at. Well, there's a couple of new things.
Did we
talk about Go Fast last time?
We did.
Okay.
I could talk a little bit more about Pokemon Snap because I've played more of it.
Cool. Do that and then we'll talk about the most exciting news.
I am several courses in Pokemon Snap and I'm very pleased with the amount of replayability with each course. I was worried about. So it seems like not every time I go back in, but every so often, the Pokemon change their patterns. Some new Pokemon show up. Like I did that jungle one at night, like several times, or well, probably 3 or 4 times. And then the last time I did it, a Leafeon showed up and I had never seen a Leafeon before that. So stuff like that is keeping me coming back. And from what I hear from other people is that there's quite a lot of content in the game to kind of justify the $60 price tag. So I was worried I would get bored with it after a few days. I've actually been enjoying it quite a lot. So returns are good so far on Pokemon Snap. It's real chill. I imagine it fits that niche of Animal Crossing did at the height of the pandemic. Like Pokemon Snap is just a very chill, fun, good time, cute time.
Because do you remember playing Pokemon Snap on 64?
I played it year before last, I believe. Yes.
So nothing changed.
I wasn't a kid. Well, absolutely changed.
No. I mean, like, in the 64 game, you had the same Pokemon show up every time.
Oh, right.
At the exact time.
Yes. Yeah, you're
so
correct.
You're saying this one is not like that. It just...
Yeah.
So,
at the start, take the very first course, for instance, there's a bunch of Bouffalant in the distance. And
what'd you call me?
You heard me, Sticky Bouffalant.
You're dumb.
So, but like the second or third time I went back, there was a Bouffalant right in front of me crossing the path. So generally speaking, the same Pokemon are showing up in the similar areas, but not always in the exact spot. So, for instance, like, I don't know, what's a good example of this? Maybe you'll see an Ariados in the tree, and maybe you won't. Especially, like, starting out. It seems like when you first start a course, it definitely doesn't have all the Pokemon there. And the more you play it, the more Pokemon are, like, being unlocked for that course for you to find. But also, you have to do... It's a puzzle game, basically. You have to do things to make chain reactions happen, so... If you throw a fluff fruit, you could stop a Pokemon from chasing another Pokemon, or you could play a melody to wake a sleeping Pokemon up and it might dance for you. Or you can throw an Illumina orb to make them glow and they might wake up and move off a rock or something. And then that'll unlock, like, there's different paths. Like you can, you typically go one direction, but on, I've noticed on at least two of them, there's like a secret path to where you can veer off and go a different direction on the course, which
that's pretty cool.
Which was when it first happened to me, I said, oh, so I was like, tricky. Ooh.
But I bet you said it exactly like that too.
Tricky. I bet you said, ooh, sticky.
My God, I'm not going to live that down, am I?
At least not this episode. But yeah, that's it on Pokemon Snap. I played it. So at first I was like, it's good. It's okay. I don't know how long it's going to keep my attention. And then now fast forward about a week, it's, oh, I'm sorry. Am I boring you?
I worked 12 hours yesterday. I'm sorry.
Oh, so did I. I got off at 2 a.m. this morning. Don't even want to hear it.
Okay.
Don't want to hear it.
Okay. One upper. Sorry, it's like my bedtime. I'm sorry.
That's okay. I'm sorry to keep you up so late.
No, you're fine.
Pokemon Snap, you go. What else did you want to talk about?
Community Day for June.
Oh, yeah. It's
oh, Dio's out.
It's Swablu.
No.
Yeah, Swablu is the next community today. You're super excited about it. What? What are we holding? Oh, she's gone. She's put her headphones down. She's walked to the window where I assume a crazed individual fan is watching her from the distance, polishing an axe on a grindstone, saying, one day that sticky girl's gonna be
what? Mine. What are you talking
what?
About?
Oh, she's back. The man behind the window did not abduct her.
No, that was Neo. He's a husky. And he's my friend.
Did you really interrupt this show to go look at a dog out your window?
Well, I was making sure he was going back home and not like, he likes to go to the garage because that's where we keep the doggy treats that we feed the neighbors. Oh, okay. Dogs. So I was making sure he was going to go back home.
Okay. So Swablu Community Day is the best community day that anyone could ever ask for and no one will.
We already talked about. No,
we did, and that's what you're talking about. It's the greatest community day that'll ever exist ever, and no one will ever be upset about it either. It's gonna have the best community day move, the best shiny, etc. And there's nothing else that can be said about any community days because after Swablu, they're not even gonna do anymore. I hear.
That'd be lame as fuck. Are you drinking Boone's Farm?
No. I'm drinking Behringer Main and Vine.
Ooh, is that pineapple and mango?
The green in the label is sharp. Because the green screen.
That's hilarious.
That's crazy looking. Yeah, it's just a fruity wine that Jasmine gave me, white sangria. Nice. Gibble!
Gibble!
Yeah, I'm talking out of my ass. It was Gibble. Wow, what
Gibble, Gibble.
The community has been waiting for Gibble forever. Unjustifiably, I think. I think just because maybe Dratini got one, everyone thought like the pseudo dragon should get them. I don't know if that's accurate or not, honestly. You say something now. I'll look something up.
Do you know how hard I've been looking for a Gibble shiny? Like, there's been, two or three different ways you could get a shiny.
Mm-hmm.
Egg hatching. And then they had... Oh, then he was in the weekly research. Yes.
Yes, I got one today, actually.
You got a shiny Gibble?
No, not a shiny Gibble. But I got a Gibble today in research.
Oh.
I do have a shiny Gibble, though, from GoFest last year. And I actually promised it away in a lucky trade. I wasn't getting back a shiny Gibble, but I was fine. I like making people happy. So it's, even though I still have it, it's technically not mine anymore. But maybe she doesn't want it anymore because of the Gibble Community Day. Who knows?
I don't think. Who were you going to give it to? Sorry, I was having a
nobody. Nobody. You know.
Okay.
So in Gen 2. Well, I eat my words on that, because the pseudo legendary dragons from the various gens do get community days. So I was thinking Dratini, and then I couldn't think of any more after that. But Tyranitar got one, Salamence got one, you know, Bagon and Larvitar.
Larvitar.
Metagross and Beldum got one, even though they're not technically dragons. They're still like pseudo legendaries. And then next in line is in fact Gible. Then it goes Hydreigon, Gudra, and Komo-o. I imagine Axew's in there somewhere. Wait, do you see Komo-o? Komo-o's fucking badass.
We need Axew.
Finishing that list is Dragapult, and Dragapult is also fucking awesome. Hannah!
I'm excited. Yeah.
Nothing, I just wanted to say your name because I'm excited you're here. Is that cool. Allowed?
I'm excited I'm here too.
Oh, ain't that cute. But it's wrong!
What is that from?
Two Stupid Dogs.
That's right.
We're
old. Oh my god! I forgot about that. Two Stupid Dogs! Two Stupid Dogs!
Anyway, this is a Pokemon show. Christ in a bucket, Brett.
Christ in a bucket.
I don't know.
That is interesting. And
yeah. Hannah, if there's nothing else that we can talk about regarding the news.
I don't know what else is going on. I'm just here.
You know plenty about what's going on, Hannah, and
that least, new
what?
I mean, what, we still have like 10 days left in
for what? Where are you going with this?
The current event that's out right now. I mean, I know this is going to be
The Luminous Legends.
Yes.
What about it?
It's just still going on.
It's just still going on.
Yeah, that's the news I have.
Yep.
Now back to you, Brett.
How are you doing in that one?
I need to battle Arlo so I can get to Giovanni.
I also need to, I'm in the exact same spot. I need to battle Arlo.
Arlo, he's like the easiest one to fight too.
Did you get the Meryl research early?
No, I was asleep.
So when I got off of work this morning, I fired the game up because it's 2 a.m. I was going to just catch a Pokemon and spin a stop for my streaks. And I saw the Meryl event and it was easy and I did a whole bunch of it.
Oh my God.
Then I read that they didn't have the shiny rates turned up, so you should stop. Then I read that, oh, go ahead and do it because they're going to just turn it on again Sunday anyway. You get double the Meryls. But by then I had already got a 100% Meryl and I got another shiny Meryl. So I got... Now I got two shiny Meryls and 100% Meryl.
You got a shiny out of the event stuff?
I did.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
Aren't you lucky?
Yeah, I got two green boogers.
I want one.
They are boogers.
They're adorable. I've been trying to...
Don't worry about that, Hannah.
Okay.
Don't worry about it.
Began when mom booked her family summer...
Jesus Christ!
In a bucket!
In a bucket. I'm sorry. I'm getting ready for this next segment and goddamn ads have to ruin the illusion that I know what I'm doing.
I thought you were like kind of saying, I thought you were going to blame it on me.
Damn it, Hannah. How could you hit the wrong buttons? I keep telling you that you're in charge of this production.
Is this Mortal Kombat theme?
That's right, Anna.
Brett.
It is time to finish off the Madness of March tournament that I started while you were gone.
Yeah, you caught me up on it a little bit.
About every other week or so when I remembered to do it, I had a randomizer pick a lot of Pokemon in this fictitious battle to the death. Over the course of it, I've had the guests pick who wins in these various bouts, and we've moved it along. Hannah, you are at the Elite Eight. We're going to take it to the Final Four, and then we're going to take it to the championship, the final round, the round to end all rounds, to behead all those that would dare step into the ring. Are you okay?
I just hiccuped. I'm sorry.
Okay. Hey, gosh, you're so excited.
Yeah, I'm stoked.
You're so excited. This is an amazing segment that I created.
I think it sounds pretty cool. I like it. I am really excited.
So just to catch you up, I won't go through the full list, but I'll go through the previous round. Duraludon smushed Brion. Vigoroth myrtleized Ninetales.
Myrtleized?
Yeah. Mind Shao actually had a bye week. So to explain the bye week, what happened was Flaffy was versus Electrode, and Electrode used self-destruct and killed each other. They killed himself and Flaffy. So Mind Shao had no one to fight against.
Flaffy, no!
Then then Vibrava beat Toxtricity. Jolteon beat Roly Coly. Greninja, Grinkildud, Combusken. Absol absolutely destroyed Cofagrigus. And then finally, Toxicroak, Maga destroyed Maganazone. Look, the jokes write themselves.
Yeah, I'm sure they do.
So in the
they are super appreciated.
We have Duraludon versus Vigoroth. We have Mind Shao versus Vibrava. We have Jolteon versus Greninja. And we have Absol versus Toxtricity. Toxicroak, excuse me. Goddamn. Absol versus Toxicroak. Hannah, starting with Duraludon versus Vigoroth, who's coming out on top of this one?
Duraludon. I think I know what that one is. You say Duraludon?
I'm sorry.
What was the first Pokemon?
Duraludon.
Duraludon?
Duraludon. Duraludon. Hannah, it is time.
Oh, Jesus, that fucking scared me.
D-U-R. I just realized what the holdup was. Duraludon, I think.
Okay, yeah, I had no idea
what. Or Ludon.
It's like an iceberg.
No, it's a steel dragon. He's made of aluminium. You can cook things on a
baking aluminium. Stone. Okay, he wins.
Just like that?
Just like that.
The Vigoroth is the murder monkey.
Yeah, but this dude is literally aluminum foil.
What does that mean to anybody?
So he shoots aluminum foil balls out of
does
his mouth.
He? Is that a thing he does?
The Vigoroth. He does now.
Oh, well, it's canon. It's Hannon. I hate myself for that joke. All right, if you say so. All right, Hannah. Mind Shao versus Vibrava.
It didn't scare me that time.
I love the sound effects now. We're going to have to do this again.
I like Mind Shao. I'm looking.
You would be the only one.
Ugh.
Vibrava, or Vibrava. Mind Shao is like a weird, like, kung fu ferret.
Well, that pulled up the... Okay. Vibrava. Pick that one.
Vibrava?
Yeah.
I think it has a type advantage against Mind Shao too, because it's flying.
Yeah, that's why I picked it.
Okay. Kind of surprised. The Vibrator wins. What's that? Do I need to watch this episode on YouTube to see what you were doing in the camera when I looked back up?
No, I didn't get it out in time. I was just going to say that's not
that's
why
what
I picked
she
that.
Said. Oh, and that's why she's sticky. Jolteon versus Greninja. Now, this is a tough one. Because on the one hand, Jolteon's an electric and has a type advantage against Greninja, who's a water.
Mm-hmm.
But Greninja is also a goddamn ninja.
Yes.
So,
and it's a frog.
A frog ninja, so...
A ninja frog.
What are you going with?
I'm going with Greninja because it's
really?
Just cool.
Just the cool factor is going to squeak it on
you
by.
You literally just said all the reasons why, even though Jolteon has a type attack against it, how he's so cool. So I picked it.
He is cool. I have it. Fun fact, he's tattooed on me. He's right there somewhere. I can't see in the thing. Where is he? Oh yeah, he's right there.
You need to save that for your OnlyFans.
Oh, yeah.
This isn't
right.
You're in the wrong show.
You're right. But wait, no, I can't do that for my OnlyFans. OnlyFans is for my feet.
You can buy a Greninja costume on Etsy.
I just want to point out that I said that and probably like 10 people probably fucking choked half to death. Going,
what'd Bleh! You say? I guess I'll have
I to. I said I can't. Maybe you need to watch this on YouTube to figure out what I said.
Maybe I need to.
I said I can't show I can't use this for OnlyFans because it's only for my feet. Fuck you.
Somebody be into it.
Absolutely versus Magnus or Toxicroak. Why do I keep doing that?
Toxicroak.
You know what Toxicroak looks like.
I know.
You
and
have a
what
shiny,
was the first one?
You have a shiny Toxicroak.
What was the first one?
Absolutely.
Absol.
Absolute vodka. He's always drunk.
I go with Toxicroak.
Okay.
You need there. Okay, so
I want to know why.
Because you need some of the underdogs to.
You do.
It's an upset. I don't know what to tell you. It's an upset.
Is it?
I just ruined somebody's bracket.
Oh, do we need to do brackets? Look, Toxicroak's got those weird sharp middle fingers that he could like with flip you off with and impale you. Maybe he gets Absol in the neck with one of those.
Yeah.
Maybe.
See? It's an upset, man. It happens.
And I'm upset. Well, then that brings us to the final round here. Well, I guess semifinal. Duraludon versus Vibrava, Hannah. Who's it going to be?
Do I know
You do. Don't you have to type it again? No, we've already been through this. You're not allowed to do that.
Why not?
Because I said.
Oh.
Yeah, the guy. You literally did the same thing twice in a row. Had to type it. D-U-R.
Why do you continuously hit me back
because it's funny.
Maybe to us, I don't know if other people,
the few people
tell us
watch.
On Twitter, tell us on Twitter if you think we're quirky, hilarious, or
no,
if we're just
no, tell us on Discord because we can talk to you back both very quickly and easily.
You're a dick. who is
that's what she said, and that's why she's sticky.
Who is Drew? Who did you say he was fighting?
Drew? Who's Drew Aladon? Hey, Drew.
Fighting.
His name is Drew. His name is Drew, and he's fighting a vibrator.
Okay, Drew Daladon wins.
Drew Daladon is the winner here.
Drew. Oh, my God. If they ever release this in Pokemon Go, I'm going to name him Drew.
I mean, they're guaranteed they're going to release him in Pokemon Go eventually.
Will we be like 55 and still playing Pokemon Go?
No, well, it'll be like 2 years from now, 3 years from now, maybe. Because he's Gen 8, I think.
So you're saying you won't be playing Pokemon Go when you're 55?
I'll probably be dead, let's be honest.
What a way to bring this down.
Greninja versus Toxicroak. I like Greninja versus Drew Aludon.
The ninja gets it.
You think so? The Toxicroak is kind of a ninja, kind of ninja-y. He's a murder stab machine.
I have made my decision.
You've made your decision, and now all that's left is Drew Aladon versus Greninja. Do we want to wait until the next exciting installment of this?
Yes. Let's see what transpires.
Send us a message on Discord. There's an After Dark Ride channel. Say who, tell us who should win, and we will take your suggestions and put it in there. And then we'll start the selection process for the next tournament. We'll get the random generator out and we'll do that and get that one going.
Two enter and one will leave. You get to choose Drew or
this.
What did you say the other one was?
Greninja. Drew,
that's what you said.
Drew Aladon or Greninja?
Drew or Gwen? Who leaves victoriously?
Okay. Did you see that new movie?
Yes, I did.
What'd you think?
It was goddamn ridiculous.
Yeah, it wasn't great. I thought it was fine.
Just like it was in the 90s, you know?
It's better than the 90s movie. This is not a Mortal Kombat podcast, but I thought it was okay. I would have liked it a lot more had I not talked to other people first. Mostly because everybody that I talked to that had seen it hyped it up and said it was freaking awesome and super gory and great and amazing. And I was really hyped about that at that point. And then it was just okay.
It was pretty, I don't know. It was okay.
Yar. Well, I guess there's only one thing left to do.
Who's that Pokemon?
Wow, for once you actually said that.
I know.
The right actual time when we were going to do that. So, congratulations.
I know. That has never happened.
Yeah. The number that it is 760. Gen 7.
Ooh.
Do you want to guess?
I already know it.
Okay. It's Beware.
What are we bewaring of?
How sticky you are. Beware, Hannah, so sticky. Hang on, I gotta write that down.
That was pretty good.
Beware is a normal fighting type introduced in Gen 7. It evolves from Stuffle and starting at level 27. So let's start there.
Stuffle, oh my god,
is the I need like that is the flailing Pokemon. It is a quadrupedal Pokemon resembling a bear cub. Its body and head are mostly pink, while its legs are brown. Each foot has a single pink paw pad on the bottom. There's a white.
It looks like... Okay, I'm going to interrupt you.
Okay, like normal, usual.
Yeah. Yeah, so Dozer has... He loves his stuffies.
Dozer is your dog.
Yes, Dozer is my personal Pokemon.
Personal Houndoom.
And they are called... I do call them stuffies, but they're these Chewy brand stuffies, and he just sits there and squeaks them, and I need to find him a stuffy in this, and we'll name it Stuffy Stuffles and the third. Yeah, that was...
Stuffle! It looks like a Build-A-Bear. It looks like a Build-A-Bear creature. It even has a tag on its butt.
Does it really?
It sure does. There's a white semicircle marking around its face, similar to a headband. It has a white muzzle with a triangular black nose. Like, it literally just looks like a Build-A-Bear bear, but pink and white.
It looks like a stuffy.
Despite its small... Despite its small size, Stuffle has extraordinary strength and can knock out even well-trained Pokemon if they are unprepared. The combination of appearance, mannerisms, and fluffy fur make it very popular.
I just mouthed yikes, and I just realized in the YouTube thing or in the video, it might look like a yes. I said yikes. I did not say
no, yes. She said yes.
No.
Yes.
No. You wish.
Did you see where Billie Eilish posed for Vogue magazine?
Yes, I did.
And she looks all sexy in all the pictures?
Yes.
Did you see the pictures?
Yes.
She looks sexy in them.
Yes.
She was 16 yesterday.
She was not 16 yesterday.
It feels like it to me.
Good for her. She needs
her. No, absolutely. She does her. Body positivity. I'm not criticizing. I'm just saying.
Well, no, like
I just feel old because when Billie Eilish became popular, she was like, she might have been even like 14 or 15. And she was popular for her music and stuff. And then now she's posing like sexily because she's an adult. And it just makes me feel old as fuck. Because people that were born when I was in high school are adults now, apparently.
Yeah. I was looking at a cast list for something. I can't remember. We were watching something.
Did you break
your arm? Like all of the actors in it are like my age. And I'm like, that does make me feel kind of old.
That's what you call when a bunch of people sign your broken arm. That's what you also call a cast list. Okay, I'll see myself out. Stuffle actually dislikes being touched and will flail its powerful arms if it is embraced, just like Hannah. Stuffle's flailing is powerful enough to break thick tree trunks. I'm thick like a tree trunk.
Back away from the Stuffle.
Despite it, is that what you tell your husband? Wait, hey, get off the phone. You're doing a show. She's flipping me off in case anyone didn't know. Despite its adorable appearance, when it gets angry and flails about, its arms and legs could knock a pro wrestler sprawling. A touch from anyone except a known friend sends it into a surging frenzy.
No means no, bitch. Pokemon.
You know what? That sounds exactly like Hannah, a surging frenzy. That's why she's sticky. It boasts power enough to split large trees in half. The organ on its rear releases an odor that it uses to communicate with others of its kind. Stuffle hates to be hugged or touched in
any way. Is that how you communicate with others?
That's correct. It will squirm, thrash, and resist with amazing power, just like all my girlfriends. Its fluffy fur is a delight to pet, but carelessly reaching out to touch this Pokemon could result in painful retaliation. The way it protects itself by flailing its arms may be an adorable sight, but stay well away. This is flailing that can snap thick tree trunks.
So that reminds me, like, I was at the cemetery, like, great shiny, walking one day. Oh, gosh. I haven't. And, yeah, there was a little dog about that size, and I went to pet it. Like, I put my hand down, which you're not, now I know you're not supposed to, like, I read somewhere, you're not supposed to put your hand out for a dog. You're supposed to just stay very still and let them sniff you, because if you put their hand out, they can bite you, which is, that's exactly what happened. This little dog bit me, and I had nerve damage for a little bit, so it kind of looks like that dog, except it's pink.
Oh, okay. I was wondering where this tied back into the Stuffle, and it's because that dog looked like a Stuffle.
Yeah.
I would touch it.
I'm giving you the
that's what she said
coolest stories right now. I'm sure it's full of
it's totally fine. Did you get the wound taken care of? You didn't get an infection? It didn't get sticky.
No, it didn't get sticky. I bled a lot, but I'm okay.
Blood can be sticky. Hannah,
do you want to see? You can still kind of like see the scar. It's like right there.
Oh, it's right, like right there. Yeah, right along the middle finger. Yeah.
I really did get bit by a dog, though.
I'm sorry to hear that.
I'm out of water.
Oh, well, you'll just have to deal with it as you read. Beware.
Beware. Should I read it in a spooky voice?
Yeah, do that until we're tired of it.
Okay. Beware is a black and pink Pokemon resembling a bipedal bear. Its legs at the front of its body.
Hold on, you kind of started, you went from spooky to sexy real quick there.
Wait, okay. Ooh, its legs. I'm trying to get back into it.
That's what she said.
This is getting out of hand. This is getting out of control. This is getting out of control.
I should drink more.
Its legs at the front of its body are black. Ooh, while its head and back and tail are pink. Oh no.
No, stepbrother. I can't anymore. This show's canceled.
Oh shit,
this is bad content. I was just laughing for like 5 minutes straight.
I don't know, laughing's pretty contagious,
is it?
Yeah. Oh,
I'm crying and that's why I'm sticky.
Yeah, me. Oh Jesus.
Yeah, you too.
In a bucket. Oh, okay.
Don't steal my things. I'll sue you.
All right. So, across the top of its head is a white band with two tufts of fur on each end.
That's what she said.
This white marking gives it the appearance of wearing a headband with decorative bear ears. Say bear, decorative bear ears 5 times fast.
Decorative bear ears, decorative bear ears, decorative bear ears, decorative bear ears, decorative bear ears.
Sounds like you were saying barriers.
Shut up.
Cheated.
Keep going.
It has a short white muzzle with a triangular black nose and two small black eyes. There are pink paw pads on its front paws consisting of the palm and three digital pads. That's a lot of paws. The hind paws have three white digital pads on the front. It has a short tail with a dark pink rings. Oh man. While beware may appear friendly.
Yeah, you lost the spooky.
While beware. Oh, Jesus. We're laughing too much. Okay. While beware may appear friendly, it is actually a very dangerous Pokemon. See, you must beware. I was legit in my spooky voice.
Yeah. It's not a ghost, though. It's true.
Oh man.
It's shiny, even considered... Shiny Gengar kind of looks like a cum ghost, but that's neither here nor there.
Ew.
Like the Mega is white. You realize that?
No.
Google it later. Mega Shiny Gengar. He's a cum ghost.
That's gross.
I didn't make the rules. Are you doing it right now?
Yeah. Oh my
god. This is not beware content.
That's disgusting.
It looks like he's like in the process of being ejaculated.
Wow. Okay, beware is considered to be the most dangerous Pokemon in Alola. Did I Alola. Say that right? Alola.
Mm-hmm.
It must never be approached carelessly, even if it's merely swinging its arms around in a friendly fashion, as this is used as a warning. How do you friendly swing your arms around?
I don't know. It's possible. Let's try it right now.
Okay.
All right. Who's going first?
You go first.
So friendly arm flailing.
Yeah.
It looks like this.
Okay, so that's like...
Can you describe what I look like?
Yeah, he looks like one of those inflatable tube guys.
That's exactly what I was going for. Yes.
But that's your whole body. And it sounds like you're knocking things over.
And now I'm stuck on like the car door at the dealership. So like now like my ass is just kind of sticking up and like maybe the other flailing inflatable arm tube man is like humping me somehow.
Yeah, everybody's seen that video.
Yeah. Yeah. They got all sticky. Your turn.
This is what I was going for.
If you came running at me doing that and I didn't know who you were, maybe if I did know who you were, I would be terrified. I would just be really confused. Could you please do that to someone at work that doesn't
come up to my patients? Woo! What's your name and date of birth?
No, don't do that because they'll think that you're pretending to be a ghost, which is really insensitive to patients in a hospital. They'll do that. Don't appear to patients going, "Hello, my name is Hannah. I need to help you." That'd be really bad. Some old lady be like, "Oh no, I'm dead. Little Billy killed me by playing ball in the house."
Oh shit.
No, just do that to a coworker. Just walk off. Don't even bring it. Don't even say anything about it. Just like
walk away.
Just walk around the corner going like this. And then just be like, "Hey Deborah, how's it going today?" "Yeah. Yeah, I've been real busy." "What, this? I don't know what you're talking about." "Oh, I'm sorry, I gotta go. See ya."
Well, it actually might be the new trend at work.
The moment they bring it up, just walk away and just do this all the way out.
Okay, I'll report my findings back to you.
Please do, and thank you.
It shows affection with a fond embrace. Now back to beware. It shows affection with a fond embrace, but its hugs have incredible force. Trainers of this Pokemon must teach it how to restrain itself when showing affection. Oh, it's like Lenny. Did you read that book?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Lenny in
Kravitz? Wow.
No. Ooh. No. Wait.
What?
Oh my god, the book like just escaped me. Anyway, its hugs are power enough to shatter bones. Many trainers are said to have left the world after receiving Beware's hugs. Beware uses its arms to subdue its prey before taking it back to its nest. They have a special nest cave.
Okay. Yours is like a black couch in a casting video. Oh! Come on, that's a good one. You weren't listening to me, were you?
I'm trying to remember the stupid book.
Yeah, you didn't even hear me.
Of Mice and Men.
That was such a good thing that I did.
Do it again.
I'm proud of my joke.
I'm proud of you. I'll listen back to it.
will you though?
Sometimes I do, sometimes I listen to our show. Hey,
what? You know that's what? A step in the right direction.
No, you know what? Okay, so Wayne, who we had on the show,
Florida Man,
he said that he never listens to an episode of his own show.
Mm-hmm. Well, the difference is that people listen to his show.
Life imitates art.
I guess so. I'm in, yeah, okay, sure. Where are we at with Beware? Are you done?
Yeah, yes, so done.
So
if I get one, I'm gonna name it Lenny.
I'm gonna name it Inflatable Arm Flailing Tube Man. The immensely dangerous Pokemon possesses overwhelming physical strength. Its habitat is generally off limits. Many trainers have left this world after their spines were squashed by its hug.
I think I read that.
The Pokemon has the habit of hugging its companions. It waves its hands wildly, intimidation and warning. Boasts tremendous physical strength. We said that. It shows affection with a hug once it accepts you as a friend.
The murder hug.
It could easily shatter your bones. The moves it uses to take down its prey would make a martial artist jealous.
So it's like a sumo wrestler.
I guess, maybe. Because the next line is that it tucks prey under its arm to carry them to its nest. But when have you seen a martial artist like tuck someone under their arm and run away with them? That's just kidnapping. Beware seems to be based on a red panda and a stuffed bear. It also has some similarities to a mascot costume. Its fighting type may be a reference to the use of wrestling bears in professional wrestling. Similarly, its type may also be related to the bear hug, a professional wrestling move used for submission. I will say that we're not doing Ruin That Pokemon today, but I will say that Beware kind of looks like a sketchy individual wearing a animal costume to like a kid's party.
I would agree with that.
Hi kids, my name's Beware. Wanna sit on my lap? No, Tammy, no. Come back over here. Stay away from this strange bear man.
But I love you.
I love you on my lap. Stepbrother. It also looks like an animatronic from like fucking Chuck E. Cheese.
Oh my God, or Billy Bob's.
Or Five Nights at Freddy's.
Where they, how would, I don't know.
You literally just had like a hiccup and you were like, how would they? And then you just said, I don't know, never mind. Maybe you should walk like a robot at work.
I suck at the robot because I'm very white.
Hello, Susie.
I have no rhythm.
Do you have those reports from the other day? Have like an intervention, like, y'all, we think Hannah's lost her fucking mind. We can't let her around the patients anymore.
Oh, man.
Hannah, let's do Torterra.
This arm's like dead.
Now.
I can't do anything with my left arm.
That's the sound. That cue means we're doing Torterrarium. Hannah's little thing that we do when we say how we take care of the Pokemon in question.
In their little Pokemon habitat.
I honestly don't. I do remember what sound clip that is. That's from MTV Cribs. Ooh.
That's great.
Hannah, why don't you go first?
Okay.
How would you take care of Stuffle and or Beware?
So, we would use caution because we have to beware of the hugs that we get. So, I would put Stuffle in their little Pokeball. I would like to have them have a place where they can feel loved and happy all the time because I wouldn't want them to get mad at me and attack me because they are very strong and they would hurt me. So I'd want to keep it happy all the time. So I'm going to put a bunch of a little forest in there with some trees that they can hug to get all their huggies out. And they're going to have in their nest, it's going to be 100% alpaca wool.
Very specific.
And have Dozer might be able to donate some of his little stuffies to put in there so they don't feel lonely. And I bet they like to eat marshmallows. So get some Jet Puff marshmallows.
It says that they like prey. They prey on something.
Bacon wrapped marshmallows.
Okay.
Marshmallows stuffed inside a turkey.
Couldn't you just feed them stuffing?
But stuffing.
Like Thanksgiving stuffing. Yeah. Stuffing for your Stuffle.
Not all Thanksgiving stuffing has meat in it, though.
And depending on where you're from, you might stuff it yourself if you try to push it through a fence. The way I'm going to do it, I'm moving on very quickly.
And I get the lashback on Twitter. Like,
shut up or be stuffed. I am going. Oh man, I totally lost my train of thought. Oh, I'm going to find like an old Billy Bob's or Chuck E. Cheese, a very old one. One that hasn't been renovated in probably a decade and is probably closed due to the pandemic. No one's been in there for well over a year. Everything's in disrepair. There's probably real life Chuck E. rats like running around the walls, moldy pizza under the bar, probably some cockroaches in the play ball pit. And I'm going to take it there and I'm going to find the skeleton of a nearby banjo bear. And then I'm going to tie up the beware to the skeleton and give it an exoskeleton so that it can learn to do the dances of the hideous creatures that you find at these establishments. And that's it. I'm just gonna, and oh, then I'm gonna hire a guy to show up at night and watch the place. And I've done this several times and everybody always dies. I don't know who keeps killing them all. Hannah, this is a Five Nights at Freddy's reference.
I haven't played that. I know what you're talking about, but I haven't played it.
I love the ooze in it. Oh, my microphone!
Uh-oh.
That sounded bad. The microphone just jumped into my lap, just like what she said.
Dozer just left. Whoops.
Oh, Dozer's mad at me now. Oh, I scared the boy. Hannah, do we have a song? Do we got anything?
Nah, I ain't got no song. I thought I did, but I don't.
Beware.
Are we gonna get sued?
You hold the future in your hand. Beware. You can win if you beware. That's good. That's Stan. That's Dare by Stan Bush. I like our new format for doing songs. I don't know if we'll do that all the time, but that was fun. I thought it was funny.
It was pretty funny.
Really couldn't think of any song that has the word beware in it. It's fucking crazy.
I just tried to think of a song and put beware in there, but
you can do your own song, Hannah. Just do it. Do your own song and then just sing it like you're a spooky person, like you did earlier.
Okay. Ready?
Yes. And I'll do the, you do the verse and I'll jump in and do the chorus.
Okay. You better beware of the bewares. They evolve from stubbles. They like to hug the tree. Is it tree Bonna?
Sure.
Better beware.
Treevana sounds like an app that you do use to order trees. Like, I want my tree Ivana now.
Trevina, something like that.
Trevenant.
Ah, it's close.
Leave a 5-star rating and review. And don't forget to tell a friend. This is Debbie and Pokemon After Dark Cry. And now it is the end. Watch me on twitch.tv/breakerstreams. Watch Hannah on the Discord that she's never on, it seems.
Can you watch things on Discord?
I think so, but I don't think that's a common thing.
See how much I know.
See how much I can't. Celacanth. Check out the other show, Jaws Breakers, the Scary Funny Shark Show, where we watch shark movies and do a podcast about that. There's new merch up for that show that's been selling like hotcakes, baby. And if you bought one, thank you so much. You can find Hannah at the hospital. If you run at somebody like this, you'll end up there. No time flat. Tell her we said hi. Hannah, do you have anything you want to say before we sign off?
Nope. Be kind, wash your hands, still wear your face mask, even though most places are telling you not to, and get your vaccine.
Yeah. What she said.
It's cool. You can get your vaccine. I've been vaccinated since January, and like my third arm is starting to come in, so I'll keep you updated on that.
Yeah, I finally have a set of balls instead of just one big one now.
Oh, that's cool. Like a set? So you have four?
No, two. I had one sphere. Doesn't everybody?
I don't know, because I don't have that.
The fuck do you mean? Running at the people like this right here. Running at them, running at
them. I feel like Meatwad. Meatwad did this.
I gotta be running at like this. I don't know. Gotta follow your arms.
You know what? Hey.
Chicken butt. Turkey butt.
So.
Goblin butt. Wait, after. Goose butt. Goose butt. Oh, yeah, we did. We got to do that.
After.
But do it spooky. Do it spooky.
Great. God damn it. After you hug all your stuffles.
Darkrai will come and throw your corpse into a duffel. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Oh, stepbrother.
Oh, this is weird. This is so fucking weird.
That's us.